Hi, my name is Riza. I'm an MBA student at IPMI International Business School, and welcome to Lessons Learned from Prof. Roy Sembel's Corporate Finance class. Lessons Learned from Corporate Finance class. So, last week, we learned about many things. We learned about capital budgeting, we learned about security analysis, we learn about alternative investments, so many things about corporate finance. So let's talk about those things.
The first key takeaway, we learn about different types of investments. There's mutual funds, there is shares of publicly listed and private companies, in which as the public or a retail investor, we can buy and sell or trade the publicly listed shares in stock exchange. And me personally, I invest in commodities, in gold, in mutual funds, and in peer-to-peer lending or P2P lending as well. Okay, the second takeaway, we learn about the concept of capital budgeting. So what is exactly capital budgeting? It is the planning process for investment in the long-term assets. And it involves in a decision-making criteria for a long-term investment proposal, whether to accept or reject that investment. There are three basic concepts of the capital budgeting. The first one, it is used to estimate expected future cash flows. And the second one, it is used to evaluate the project based on the criteria, which we will learn in the next slides. And the third one is to decide which project is good and bad based on the evaluation. Okay, so there are three capital budgeting methods that use to decide whether an investment is good or not, and whether to accept or reject that investment proposal. The first one is payback period. Well, payback period is the time required to recoup the funds expended in an investment, or you can say to reach the break-even point. And mostly the shorter the period is better. And then there's net present value or NPV, which is the calculation used to calculate today's value of a future stream of payments. Basically, if it's above zero, you should accept it, and the higher is the better. Okay, and then there's the internal rate of return. It is the discount rate that makes NPV zero. And as you can see here, if the IRR is greater or equal than the required rate of return, then you should accept the proposal. If it's below the required rate of return, then you should reject it. And then the last one, there's profitability index. It is a measure of a project's or investment attractiveness, which is calculated by dividing the present value of future expected cash flows by initial investment amount of the project. So naturally, if it's above or equal to one, you should accept it. And if it's below one, you should reject it.
So that is the lessons learned from last week's class. I'll see you all again next week. Cheers.